Do you feel annoyed every time you look at your payslip at the end of the month? Does it feel like you're getting ripped off by paying too much in tax? What if you could boost your income by about £7,500 tax-free per year? If the thought of showing the middle finger to the tax man excites you, then you're in the right place, my friend. In this video, I'll go over how you can earn an extra £7,500 per year without having to pay any sort of tax, legally, of course. I'll also include a bonus at the end, which can help you further boost that amount by about 13%. So make sure you watch this video until the end. Hi guys, my name is Marius and welcome to Money Employed. If this is your first time here and would like to join our community of money employers and finance junkies, then consider subscribing. Also, if you like the video, please make sure to hit that like button because it really helps out the channel. Now, before we get into the video, I just want to make it clear that this is not a get rich quick thing or a gimmick or a scam or whatever you want to call it, okay? Everything I'll be talking about is 100% legal and even encouraged by the government. So if you're sick and tired of working hard and putting in the extra hours at your job just so that the taxman can take his share before your salary even hits your bank account, then what I'm about to show you will definitely put a smile on your face. This is by no means something new or revolutionary, but it's most probably something you're not taking advantage of and you probably should. So what am I talking about here? Well, back in 1992, probably around the time I was being conceived, if you think about it, the UK government introduced the Rent a Room scheme. It was mainly designed to help ease housing problems in the country by encouraging people to let out spare rooms in their homes to lodgers and receive a tax relief for doing so. Basically, by doing this, every year you could earn up to a certain amount in rent from a lodger without having to pay a single penny in tax on it. Sounds good so far? Up until March 2016, this amount was £4,250, but the threshold was increased to £7,500 in April the same year. One thing I do want to mention is that individuals can make up to £7,500, but if you share the income from the property with someone else, say for example your spouse, you can only claim up to £3,750 each. That, for most people, is still a significant amount of money if you think about it. At the time of this recording, the £7,500 threshold still stands, meaning you can earn up to £625 tax-free per month if you choose to let out a room in your home to a lodger. Now just think about it. How much overtime would you have to do at your job in order to make that extra £625 every single month? How much would you have to sacrifice in terms of time and effort to achieve that? Well, let's look at some statistics, shall we? The average salary in the UK in 2019 was just over £29,000, meaning that after income tax, national insurance, and a usual 4% monthly pension contribution, the average earner would take home each year £22,530, or 1,877.50 pence per month. To make an extra £625 per month after tax, the average earner would require a before tax yearly salary of over £40,500. That's more than £11,000 extra you would have to earn from a job to reach that amount. I think it's safe to say that you would have to work a crazy amount of overtime and probably even get a second job in order to achieve that. Now you might think that because this is such a great opportunity to make a decent amount of extra cash, tax-free no less, you must be a homeowner to qualify, right? Well, that's actually not the case. You don't have to be a homeowner to take advantage of the scheme. You can do this even if you're a tenant. However, if you do rent where you live, you will have to ask your landlord for permission to sublet. As a homeowner, on the other hand, to take a lodger in, you will need permission from your mortgage provider. Although it's unlikely they will have any objection, so don't worry too much about it. But in both cases, you will need permission from your home insurance provider to do this, so just be mindful of that, yeah? There are also a couple more conditions that must be met in order to qualify for the tax relief offered by the rent room scheme. So make sure you're aware of these before you let out a part of your home. First of all, it goes without saying that the room you let must be in your main residence, meaning that you must also live in the property, although, as I mentioned earlier, you don't have to own the property. And don't forget that there's a clear difference between a tenant and a lodger. A lodger is someone who lives with you in your home and shares living space with you, such as the kitchen, bathroom, or living room. A tenant, on the other hand, is someone who pays rent for a property that you own but don't live in. In this case, you're classed as a live-out landlord. However, there is an exception here, and I think you should be aware of this. If you're a live-in landlord but you don't share living space with the person renting from you, then they're actually classed as a tenant, not a lodger. So let's say the lodger would live in a self-contained part of your property, say for example like a studio where they have their own bathroom and kitchen. Well, in this case, you wouldn't qualify for the tax relief on the rent earned. Secondly, the room or rooms you let must be furnished and for the lodger or lodgers to live in, not to run a business. So the scheme doesn't apply to letting out space as an office. This also means that you can't rent a room for storage either if you want to benefit from the tax relief. Now, although the following points don't affect the tax treatment of your income under the scheme, you still need to comply with them. First, you'll need annual gas safety checks done on your boiler and provide smoke alarms and fire resistant furniture. If you're renting, then this should already be covered by your landlord. It's also a good idea to get any electrical equipment PAT tested as well, although this is not essential. Secondly, if you're living on your own and you qualify for the 25% single person council tax reduction and decide to rent out a room, you will no longer qualify for the discount. However, if your lodger is a student, this won't be the case, so keep that in mind. And lastly, please be aware that if you have more than two lodgers, your house will count as a house in multiple occupation, aka HMO, and you'll have to comply with a range of extra health and safety regulations. I would suggest you don't get more than two lodgers at the same time, because doing it really isn't worth the extra costs and effort. So how can you find a lodger to live with you and help you make some extra cash for that holiday you've been dreaming about, or to pay off some of your mortgage? Well, there's a few websites you can use, the most popular one obviously being Spare Room. Another great and popular one is Easy Roommate, and if you're very desperate, Gumtree is a good place as well. Also consider the Facebook Marketplace and Facebook groups dedicated to like renting, because those are also good places to find lodgers. Asking friends or family if they know anyone who's looking for a room is another great way to find a lodger, because they can recommend you someone who they actually trust. One thing to consider as a live-in landlord is that you should get your lodger to sign a license in which you set out the conditions of their stay in your property, as well as outlining any house rules before they move in. If you don't want to pay a solicitor to draft one up for you, you can actually get a lodger agreement pack from Amazon. I'll leave a link to it in the description below if you want to have a look at it. Now, if you don't want someone to live with you 24/7, which is understandable, what you can do is you can let out the room on a website like Airbnb. And doing this can even allow you to charge more for the same room. However, if you decide to let a room in your home on Airbnb, you need to consider the extra management work that you will have to do, as well as the host fee charged by Airbnb, which is typically around 3%. If you're looking for something more passive, then this probably isn't the way to go. As I mentioned earlier, letting out a room on Airbnb can allow you to charge more. But what happens if you end up making more than the £7,500 threshold? Normally, if your lodger pays you less than £7,500 per year, you will automatically be exempt from any tax on this income, and you don't need to do anything except keep a record of the income. But if you do go over the threshold, you will need to complete a tax return, and there are two ways to pay tax at this point. A, you can choose to pay tax on profits like a normal business. So basically, you would take the total income you've made in the year from rent, deduct from it expenses such as gas, electricity, internet, etc., and pay tax on what's left. And B, the second way you can choose to pay taxes at this point is to take the first £7,500 tax-free and then pay income tax on any excess rent. Bear in mind that if you choose this option, you cannot claim any expenses. Now, if you do go over the threshold, the way you should pay tax will really depend on the amount of expenses you've incurred as a result of letting out the room or rooms. So let's look at a quick example. Let's say that you're single and you've bought yourself a 3-bedroom house. Because you miss living with your housemates and would like to have someone else pay off your mortgage, you decide to take in two lodgers and charge them £400 per month each in rent. The annual rent you will therefore receive is £9,600, which is £2,100 more than the £7,500 threshold under the rent a room scheme. Let's also assume that the yearly expenses of having two lodgers are a total of £2,400. If you choose to pay tax according to option A, you will need to take the yearly rent of £9,600 minus £2,400 in expenses, which will leave you with £7,200 in profit. Because your top rate of tax is 20%, this means that the amount in tax you will have to pay on your profit is £1,440. Effectively, after expenses and taxes, you would have made £5,760. If, however, you choose to pay tax according to option B, you have to take the yearly rent of £9,600 minus the £7,500 tax-free allowance, which leaves you with £2,100 to be taxed at 20%. In this example, you would end up paying a total of only £420 in tax. That's more than three times less what you would pay if you were to use option A, not to mention that you would have made £6,780 after covering the expenses and taxes. So basically, it all comes down to your personal situation, if you want to pay tax on your profits or on any excess rental income above the tax-free threshold. Also, you don't have to stick to the same method of paying tax each year. You can change year to year as long as you let HMRC know about it. Now, remember I mentioned that I'll give you a bonus at the end of the video that will increase the amount you can make each year tax-free by about 13%. Here it is. In addition to the rental room tax-free allowance that I talked about previously, you can earn an extra £1,000 per year tax-free by renting out parking space in your garage or your driveway. If you live close to a train station, airport, stadium, city center, or event arena, you can make an extra £100 a month from doing this. To get an idea of how much you can make, based on your area obviously, you can check a website called parklet.co.uk, and I'll leave a link to it in the description below so you guys can go and check it out. So there it is, how to easily make a good amount of extra money every month and year before you even need to pay any tax on it. Now, this might not be something you'd be willing to do, but it's definitely worth considering because you are leaving a lot of money on the table. So with that said, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and have gotten a lot of value out of it. If you have, please make sure to hit the like button and comment below to let me know your thoughts about this subject. I really want to know what you guys think about this opportunity and if any of you are currently making good use of it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.